Hello, I'm back to look at some more newly unveiled upcoming Lego sets for 2022, and I'm also here to correct a great wrong. Because I looked at the new city stuff. You just go to lego.com and you look for stuff that's new and filter by city and coming soon, and there's one missing. There's a really important one missing. It's hospital. So the hospital set is on the site, but it didn't show up in that list, and that's...
How embarrassing. How embarrassing.
Okay, the most important one that I need to look at. Well, make up for it now. $120. We've been looking for a new hospital for regular minifigs from Lego for a long time. And this one actually looks pretty decent to me. 816 pieces. Many of those pieces are... larger than average. Quite many of these pieces are larger than average. So don't look too carefully, too closely at the price to part ratio. I do think that this is overpriced. I would like to see it at about $100, but hopefully we'll see some sales in the US. It is 100 euros though, which is a little bit better just relative to what we normally would get. First impression on this from me, I'm looking at it, I'm expecting, okay, am I going to be disappointed? This is cut off too much. This is too narrow. No, actually, I'm not disappointed. I'm actually pretty happy with the fact that they did a different shape. I like this overhang with the underpass, with the driveway. It's a good use of the road plates in this one. I like the curvature. The color scheme is nice. That's a dark azure as the accent color there. The ambulance is good in size. I wish that the box was a little bit longer. If this was 1 to 2 studs longer, I think just one stud longer actually would have been good enough so that this could have been closed up here and have an enclosed box. Although I don't know, there are pros and cons. I like the color scheme, don't like the side right here with just that one sticker up there in the corner. The minifig selection is really good. I'll just show you the... Yeah, they do. Okay, they were good. I can't. But a lot of minifigs, a lot of variety, some new torsos in there, and also they include a squirrel, which is going to make people happy. Definitely, because, you know, at least in toy form, squirrels are cool. Sometimes in person, they can get a little bit annoying if there are too many of them. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna look at the details here pretty soon, but I'm just looking at the overall shape of it. It kind of makes sense. Like it fits within a square. It also that inverted corner kind of thing, and it's accessible. Yeah, look. And this is wow. What is that? Is that one set or two? That's got to be two sets, right? Wow, it's down by the shore. I'm looking forward to seeing what this set is or what these sets are. That's going to be interesting. Okay, well, let's look at the details of the inside, which is some of the more important stuff. This is like a little kid's room off to the side, and those look more like stackable wooden blocks to me than Duplo or Lego, you know, which is interesting because it looks like a suggestion that Lego is recognizing that buildable things exist outside of the world of Lego. Like, they could have made this a stack of Lego sets, but they didn't. I like that. Really nice sticker back here. It is a sticker. This, I'm assuming, is a print. That's cool. Okay. Let's see some of the more important stuff. Oh, this is the lobby area, so the waiting space. Another new build for a water cooler. And... are those like a cheese sandwich and a ham sandwich, or like cold cuts. So this is like a cafeteria. Okay, that's actually a good use of this space. I appreciate the inclusion of a stud right there so you can have somebody at the water cooler. Yeah, not a bad use of a very small space. This is radiology, so imaging. Does this slide in and out? Does the gurney slide in and out? I think it can. That's good. I mean, it's really simple how it's done, but I think they did that pretty decently using some of the new newer versions of prints there. Okay. Again, for a small space, a maternity ward, which can also be used for other things, you know, because it just has a bed. I mean, you know, a lot of kids will use this as an emergency room, you know, ICU or whatever, because it has a bed. But the fact that it can be used as a maternity ward also adds a lot of value, and it has a restroom as well, which actually looks kind of nice. Needs some studs down here. Like a couple of these should have been jumpers, but the colors work. It is kind of small. Like, these are not large kids. Overall, it's smaller than it looked to me. Yeah, definitely. I would have preferred this to be 100 or less. Maybe even I could have even asked for like 90. I could even ask for it to be 80. Honestly, looking at this picture now, as small as it is, I know that we would not. What was that? I know that we would not get it for 80, but I could ask for it. Hopefully we'll get this on sale, but it's $120, 100 euros. I didn't look at the price in the UK. I appreciate the fact that the helicopter is small and does not use up too many pieces, because they easily could have made a huge helicopter here and then taken a bunch of detail out. I'm glad that they went for this silly small helicopter. I don't think it's able to actually carry a gurney. I wish that it was. If it worked as a basic, very simple medevac chopper, that would have helped a lot. But they have the medevac chopper in a separate set. Still, I'm just saying, just have a clip on the side would have been enough to hold on to a gurney. But overall, I'm pretty happy with this, except for the price. Most important thing is the building. Though it is small, with my old person nostalgia, I have to be honest and say, back in the old days, when Lego was actually good, they would not have done better than this for a hospital. With amount of detail, nostalgia can push you in the direction of saying, hey, well, you know, everything when I was a kid was better because it looked better. So anything that doesn't look like what I saw and liked as a kid is now bad. But if you actually look at the details that are there, this is done better than, this may be one of the best hospital or medical related sets that Lego has ever done, design wise. This is also a thing. This is on BrickSet.com, but it's another city thing, so I just wanted to show it. It doesn't show up on the Lego website yet, but it's coming up. It's just a couple of figures and some basic little park related stuff. Kids playground, they call it. Not a whole lot of a playground, is it? But you know, it is what it is. You can, okay, there's not a bigger image of it. That's fine. See what it is. Don't know exactly how much it's going to cost or where it's going to be, but it's probably going to be the usual polybag distribution. This doesn't show up in the browse list for upcoming new stuff, but I was able to find it on the site by just searching by number. A new train. I feel like I should be mad about this because it's not a new city train. You know, it's not a new minifig compatible train. It's not even a creator expert train. But I'm not mad at it because it looks good and it's $20. And you can buy two and then connect them and it'll look even better. I would not be opposed to them re-releasing narrow gauge rail and doing a line of these. There we go. There's what it looks like with two, which is great. I just hope that this is not all they're going to give us for trains for the next 2 or 3 years. I hope that this is not all they're going to give us for trains for this year, even. I hope that they're going to do a train like this as a creator expert thing, you know, a full-size big one. I really hope. Because if this is it for trains for now, that trains are selling that poorly, that's so sad for me as a train fan. I'll have to rely on just doing mocks, but still, this looks really good to me. It even has suggestions of doors, which they don't do very frequently in trains. But yeah, I'm not mad at it. $20 and 284 pieces right there on the box. I'm not mad at it. Really not. I should be, but I'm not. Oh, you know what? The trucks don't turn though, so it probably actually would not go around turns on a 4-wide railway. Darn. Here's another one, another creator set that's coming up that they haven't put pictures for, at least that I didn't find, on their regular part of their website. This is on the kids side, but it's the new Majestic Tiger with some interesting building techniques. Just that's a print there, cheese slope 1x2, but then this is all built. So that's a plate there, that's a curve, that's the other, the concave topped curve piece. It's just interesting builds to create the nice shapes there. I'm happy to get these. Oh wait, those eyes are actually built. Wish I could zoom in on this. Yeah, that's actually built. I don't see what exact technique that is. I hope that's not what I think it is. But I'll wait to see. Interesting, the way that these are designed, you could add claws to them if you wanted. Nice little bird off to the side, a little stream and everything, some bamboo, I guess that's representing something like that. And then it's a 3-in-1, so one of the alternate builds is this koi, which looks perfectly good. Got the whiskers there. This is all nice, a little water. Is that water? Is this supposed to be underwater? I think this is supposed to be underwater, not beside the water. Maybe? Not sure, but it looks good. You know, it doesn't use a lot of pieces. And then the red panda. Nice. Mm-hmm. Very nice. And this is obviously above water. Yeah, this is well done. I like it. This is going to be $50 US. I haven't seen the prices elsewhere. Oh, you can actually change the angle of the fin up here as well. Got the new ball joint piece, ball socket piece. Keep forgetting to call that out. It just exists. Do I have something else? I think I have, yeah. Sunflowers. $13 for two sunflowers. Not in the botanical line, but in the creator line, where they also had the roses and the tulips. These look nice. They use the little leaf foliage pieces and then lots of oars. Lots of oars. This is the oars battle pack for you. Just regular yellow color. You can spend a lot of time adjusting the angles of them to make them feel and look just right. But yeah, not bad. Not bad. Can you angle this up a little bit? Because, I mean, here, these are hanging down so much. I don't like that look, personally. It's another one where you need to get the right vase, the right vase to hold them right, because they're really going to be top-heavy. That looks like it's angled up. And then this one looked like... Oh, is one of them angled up and one of them angled down? Is that what's going on here? Or are they both exact... I don't know. At least with a little bit of customization, maybe a couple extra pieces, you can change the angles of them. But yeah, and then there are these two postcard sets, $15 here. This looks good. New York, almost all the decorations are stickers. But to get the new Lady Liberty figure, we haven't had the Lady Liberty figure in a long time. It's nice to get a new one of that. It will help with, you know, just people that want something that looks like that, but don't want to pay exorbitant aftermarket prices. I support that. That's the little fairy going under there as well. I just noticed lots of stickers, too many stickers, but a really nice concept and a nice shape and overall design for this. And then they have a Beijing postcard as well, done in the same sort of style. And I'm assuming that this is going to be an entire line for a lot of tourist destinations that they're going to do things like this. I like the overall presentation. The whole thing. Yes, go ahead. Do it. Make more. Excellent. Thanks for watching. Sorry about missing the hospital last time, but I'll try to be better and talk to you again soon. Bye for now.